Right Honorable Lego Idagbo is the chairman local content monitoring and development in the National Assembly House of Representatives. He's been at the forefront of championing a local content bill, and prior to now, a local content government's perception about local content has always been oil and gas, and we cannot say we blame them, because about 90% of our revenues and income actually come through oil and gas. But ICT is making a very strong claim, getting up to 14% of the current GDP, and its position to do a lot better. So this is the reason why we decided that we needed to have the Right Honorable Lego on this platform to be able to give us a presentation as to how the local content bill will incentivize or drive local innovation, which is critically needed, and also to protect the integrity of our information assets and data. We would be hearing from him in the next minute or so for his paper. So, Honorable Lego, you have the floor.
Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. This is just test running my audio and video. I hope you all see me very well. And I hope you hear me too.
We do. Go on, please.
All right. Thank you very much, Chris. Let me formally introduce myself again, even though Chris has done justice to that introduction. I am Right Honorable Lego Idagbo. By the grace of God, I happen to be the chairman House Committee on Nigerian Content Development and Monitoring. It's been my pleasure to be part of this webinar. And Chris, yesterday when we spoke, incidentally, I was in my constituency. I was not too sure of the network there, but I'm speaking today from Calabar, which is like a 3.5 hour drive from my constituency. So I made that drive in the morning just to be part of this webinar. That underscores the importance I have for this webinar. It's important to me because it's coming at the time where, as a committee, we are sponsoring the Nigerian Content Development and Enforcement Bill. Before now, like Chris had mentioned, local content was restricted only to the oil and gas sector. It's had its successes, it's had its challenges, mostly successes. And I will tell you just a brief story of the successes of the local content bill, which was signed into law in 2010. In the oil and gas sector. Before the local content bill was signed into law, the oil and gas sector was dominated by expatriates. The Nigerians were begging for crumbs. Even in their localities where oil operations were taking place, they didn't have a say. So the Nigerians clamored for a bill that would give them a say, which is what happens in every other crime. Luckily, the National Assembly rose to the occasion, and this bill was passed and signed into law. The benefits of this bill, what the bill sought to achieve, was basically to say that let us see how we can grow capacity in that sector, and let us see how we can grow capacity of our indigenous companies and encourage them to do well in the sector. You know, and we've had successes. I'll tell you a story of Lavin Energy. Lavin Energy is one of the companies that were able to lay hands on the funds, because there's a deduction of 1% from every oil contract that has been awarded. And that deduction of 1% is put in a trust fund that is overseen by the board, NCDMB, Nigerian Content Development and Monitoring Board. So the board oversees that fund and they work in partnership with Bank of Industry. So Bank of Industry was able to give out some funds to some Nigerian companies, and Lavin was one of the beneficiaries. They built capacity as a result of those funds. They took part in the sector because there's a provision in our law that says if a foreign company comes to do business in Nigeria, you must work with a local partner, a Nigerian company. So that way, there are certain things that are stipulated in the bill that should be handled by only Nigerians. The Nigerian company that is your local content partner will ensure that those things go to Nigerians. And as they are doing that, they are building capacity. That way, they can compete because the oil and gas sector is a closed sector. If you do not have any experience in the sector, it's difficult for you to gain entry into it. They'll ask you questions like, have you done anything oil and gas before? So you need to show that you have. Today, Lavin Energy is winning bid rounds in other countries, in Equatorial Guinea, in Benin Republic. They are winning bid rounds for oil blocks in those countries. And those are huge contracts. Why are they winning these bid rounds? Because they've been able to show capacity back home in Nigeria. And these other countries look up to us. Tomorrow, with what is happening, you never can tell. They can begin to win contracts globally, even in the UK, in Asia, in the US, and so on. So that is what the oil and gas sector has been able to achieve. One last example in the oil and gas sector is Oil Serv. Oil Serv built the longest gas pipeline in Nigeria, and they got their funding from Bank of Industry, this 1% deduction that was made in the sector and domiciled under the watch of the board in Bank of Industry. They got their funding. They did that job. Today, they've won the contract for AKK. I'm sure everybody knows what AKK is. It's the Ajokuta-Kaduna-Kano railway line. Oil Serv is the major contractor. Now they are having to look for technical partnership with the Chinese. So the Chinese have now come in as their partner. You know, before it would have been them coming in as a partner to a foreign company. Now a foreign company is having to come in as their partner to handle some technical issues. So as a committee and as a house, we saw the successes and we decided that it was important that we expand the gains that had been achieved in the oil and gas sector to every other sector of the economy. And I must say this year that sectors are different. If you do copy and paste, you're going to get it wrong, particularly with ICT. ICT is a sector that is peculiar. What obtains in ICT may not obtain in construction, may not obtain in manufacturing, of course, in oil and gas, in agriculture, in health, and other sectors. You know, so we must treat every sector based on their peculiarities. That's why in our bill, we had a lot of omnibus clauses. This bill will be circulated to every stakeholder, to every sector. We had calls to engage with all the sectors. We invited the Minister for Communications. Thankfully, the DG, is it DG? He's called NCC? Yes, Executive Secretary, Nigerian Communications Commission, was with us. He did a presentation. NITA came to the National Assembly and also did their own presentation on how they thought the ICT could function best. And we're able to capture all of that into our proposed law. So now, if I'm to speak specifically about ICT, what we are trying to achieve is post-COVID-19, because this COVID-19 pandemic has made it clear that Nigeria has to reverse the trend of being a net importer of information and communication technology. We need to begin to look inwards. Someone said COVID-19 has presented challenges to the ICT sector. I would rather want to say it's presented opportunities to the ICT sector. Opportunities that if the ICT sector can key into, they would grow with unprecedented pace. In Nigeria, for instance, I don't know, but I think the ICT sector is challenged And we need to take this opportunity that COVID-19 has presented, because everybody is going ICT. See this webinar we're having today. On a lighter note, 3-4 weeks ago, someone called me and said, I've been invited to a webinar. I said, what does webinar mean? They said, no, it means you will go online and make. I said, I cannot stress myself. I don't want to go into all that trouble. Anybody that wants to see me should come. Let's meet physically and discuss. And look at me today. I know how to set it up. I know how to navigate everything. I needed to call someone to show me how to do all of that. And this is me functioning in a webinar and speaking to you fine gentlemen. You know, so it's not rocket science. Anybody that thinks ICT is rocket science is being misinformed. In other climes, people that are not even educated go into ICT and rise to the pinnacle of it. They tell you stories of how people like Mark Zuckerberg were dropouts of school, probably Bill Gates and the rest of them were dropouts of school. This is because you do not need that advanced education to be an expert in ICT. The time is calling, and it's now, that we must expand and build capacity inwards and in country in ICT in Nigeria. This bill we are proposing is to institutionalize local content across all sectors of the economy and protect startup businesses seeking to participate in the digital economy. Whether we like it or not, the economy has gone digital. It's no longer analog. Everything that used to happen in an analog economy with the coming of COVID-19 will cease. Even if COVID-19 goes, which we all pray it does, but because of how we've learned this new way of life, it's more convenient, trust me, than to ask people to travel back and forth for meetings. Recently, Twitter sent a message to all their staff that they don't need to come to work ever again, you know? And that's to say that with technology, you can work effectively. So moving forward, I think that our local content bill channeled to ICT is the best thing that will happen to Nigeria. But again, I'm just a legislator. I'm not an expert in the sector. So I don't have all the answers and I don't know everything. But all I'm saying is that we're providing a platform, a legislative platform where you can interface with us and tell us that, okay, ABCD is what we want to see happening using your legislation in the sector. And of course, we'll oblige you. We've sent out communications to every stakeholder. We've sent out communications to your minister, a draft of our bill, and we're asking you to send memorandum, and we're going to engage with you, not physically because of COVID-19. We'll engage with you, webinars, Zoom meetings, conferences, and all that, just to get your inputs and tailor our bill in such a way that it gives you guys in the sector a fighting chance. All we want to see, because we must protect our country. It's unheard of where you see foreigners coming to manage our data. Tomorrow, if something happens, God forbid, they have the power. They can shut us down. They have all the information that concerns us. So we need to build our own local companies that will manage our data, that will take charge ICT-wise. See what's happening in Silicon Valley. Why can we not have one of such in Nigeria? The Indians did it in the city of Bangalore. The Indians now control their ICT. And so many young Indians are MDs in Fortune 500 companies. We can do that for our country using this local content bill. So for us, we've provided this platform and we want you guys to key into it. We want to have robust engagement with you guys. Want you guys to look at all the details of our bill, wherever we need to put in certain specifics, tailor-driven towards giving you guys robust opportunity in the sector indigenously. You let us know and we'll be sure to do that. Again, I thank you. I hope I kept to my time and prepared to take any questions as they arise. Thank you very much, Chris. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much, Honorable. We will, I think questions can be taken at the end of the session. We will go right into the next paper, but very salient things you mentioned. We are happy to work with your team. We have received an official request from your office as an official memorandum to bring in our input, and currently as a policy for the Digital Economy Policy Commission, this is top of mind in our priority list, because we feel it is an opportunity to speak to areas of the Nigerian data protection regulation, localizing inputs into e-government projects coming in from the federal ministries, and to have Nigerian companies sort of like be the ones to build up that digital economy. Thank you for your time, and we apologize for the drive we had to make you go through, but I am sure that if the digitization process gets to you won't have to make that drive next time. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
We'll have you towards the end.